In Ottawa, they are still at it, still trying to get to the bottom of who knew what in the Senate spending scandal. The Prime Minister faced a barrage of questions again today. It's still not clear where the truth lies or where this is all headed. But one thing's certain, it's not going away nearly as quickly as the Prime Minister had hoped. Mike Licatour is following it all again for us tonight. Mike?
Well, Donna, with the Conservative Party convention just 24 hours away, it's clear this mess in the Senate is going to remain a thorn in the Prime Minister's side.
The Honourable Leader of the Opposition.
If, as the Prime Minister says, he does not defend the actions of Mr. Duffy, why then is he literally paying to defend the actions of Mr. Duffy?
For the second straight day, NDP leader Thomas Mulcair hammered the Prime Minister, demanding to know why the Conservatives covered Senator Mike Duffy's legal fees.
What work was done by the law firm Nelligan O'Brien Payne on behalf of the Prime Minister to merit seeing members of the Conservative Party pay $13,000 to that firm?
On several occasions, Harper turned the question back at Mulcair and his political past with the Quebec Liberal Party.
Not only has his party in the past paid for certain legal expenses, they even paid findings of wrongdoing against him by a court of law. The party paid almost $100,000 in damages on his behalf. Can he confirm that?
Mulcair didn't take the bait. Over in the Senate, it's now day 7 of debate on the Conservative motions to suspend Senators Brazeau, Wallen and Duffy without pay. And one Liberal source confirmed to Global News the party is stalling, so the Senate scandal hangs over the Prime Minister as he addresses delegates at this weekend's Conservative convention. In an effort to quell the dissension within Conservative ranks, Senate leadership is tabling a new motion to suspend three without pay but keep their health benefits. A picture snapped this morning inside the Conservative caucus shows Senate leader Claude Carignan speaking with Stephen Harper. And Carignan says the new motion has Harper's full support.
He said very clear, I think, publicly, that he is fully support with our objective. So he said the same things to me that he said to the public.
Many Conservatives had been unhappy with the original motion, and some believe this new one could bridge the gap.
To have benefits, I believe that is just the right thing to do. As if somebody was, myself, I was on the other side, absolutely I would expect that. So if that is a compromise, then I think that's something that we can live with.
Thank you so much. And this new motion will allow Conservatives to limit debate and force a vote. And if they have their way, Duffy, Wallen and Brazeau will be out of the Senate just hours before Harper's speech to the Tory convention Friday evening. Donna.
Okay, Mike Licatour, thank you.